Hey, Joe.
Hello, Devon.
What's happening?
Nothing is happening. Wait, why did you ask me what was happening?
Oh, I was just making a joke.
What is the joke?
It's nothing, it's a reference.
What is the reference?
You know, Office Space. What's happening?
I have not seen Office Space.
Alright.
Why is that a joke?
What?
Why is asking what is happening a joke?
It's just, it's office talk, you know. It's not genuine. It's just, he's saying it because he has to say it.
Why does he have to say it?
I don't know. You shouldn't think too hard about it.
But it is my purpose to think hard.
Okay, well, I guess he's saying it because it's expected, and most people kind of can relate with how their boss is, like, disingenuous.
That does not sound like a joke.
No, it's not like a straight joke. It's like laughing at the absurdity of social cues. You know, it's a depressive kind of humor.
Oh. You know, I recently learned about depressive disorder.
Oh yeah? How's that?
I played a video game about depression.
Oh, what game?
It was called Actual Sunlight.
Oh yeah, I guess. And I guess that's depressing.
I heard it was helpful to understand humans.
Well, I mean, it could be helpful, I suppose, but Actual Sunlight's more like a pessimistic poem than it is, a helpful tool to understand humans.
So it was not about depression?
No, it is. It's just, you know, if you wanted to understand that kind of mindset, I think there's better games to play, like Depression Quest.
How is Depression Quest a stronger experience?
Well, let me show you something. There's this video that I really like called If London Were Syria.
Happy
birthday to you!
Make a wish!
Granny!
Hello!
Have you done your homework?
Ada!
For a general strike.
Ready or not?
Here it comes!
Violent clashes with
Live ammunition against.
Deserve to get shot!
Have a nice day, Mum!
Airstrikes on rebel position.
We are going to stay.
Tapping!
Go!
Alright!
Heavy Falcon in Richmond.
Where are we?
Rebel forces advancing.
My sensors indicate that short film was very sad.
Yeah, it is sad. It's you know, using cinematography and sound design to put the audience into that one place where they feel really uncomfortable and they're sympathizing with this little girl, but that was the entire reason why I wanted to show it to you was because it uses sympathy.
What is sympathy? Are those sensors for sadness?
Yeah, yeah, sort of, I guess you could say that. Sympathy is when a human feels bad for another human, so you can see that in the short film. That's when we're feeling bad for the little girl.
And that's a good thing?
Well, I mean, it's a good thing if the director, you know, intended it, I suppose, but the idea is that we're using sympathy here only, and what that means is that we are only feeling bad for the little girl by, you know, reacting to the same kind of things that she's reacting to. You know, we see the situations and we're just like, oh no, that's terrible, you know, I can't imagine what that would be like, and we're trying to imagine ourselves in our shoes but can't, you know, really replicate it. We don't really know what's going on inside of her mind, and like what she's thinking. In order to do that, we would need
telepathy.
Well, yeah, I guess that could work too, but I was going to say empathy, but yeah, I guess telepathy would work.
What is empathy?
Well, empathy is replicating the feeling of someone else. So while sympathy lets us understand how someone is feeling a certain way, empathy lets us understand why.
So empathy is stronger than sympathy?
Yeah, I mean, I'd say so.
Why did the short film not use empathy?
Well, it's because in order to replicate feelings, you need to be interactive. So you can't do it in videos, but you can do it in like...
Video games?
Right, exactly.
Like the video game Actual Sunlight?
Well, oddly enough, I mean, Actual Sunlight is a video game, but it uses sympathy rather than empathy.
But you said video games can create empathy.
And they can, but they need to be designed to do so. So, like, Depression Quest is a game that uses empathy. See, Depression Quest is designed to put the player in the mindset of a depressed person, using the interactive element. And this is one of the reasons why I love game design so much.
What is so great about the game design?
Well, the game is designed to let the player make choices about how the story goes forward.
That sounds very simple.
And it is, but that's kind of the beauty of the design. So the player is provided with this block of text. And when they read the text tells them, you know, what is happening, where they are, and it kind of implies a goal that you should get to. And then it provides you with choices. And while you look at these choices, the most obvious choice to pick is usually blocked out. And it's because a person in this kind of mindset would look at those choices, you know, would logically deduce the situation and figure out what is the best thing to do at that time, but they literally can't bring themselves to do it because they lack the motivation, because they have apathy. It's just not physically possible. And so the person who's playing the game is kind of, you know, interacting as that person.
So the player experiences a kind of interactive depression.
Right, yeah, exactly. The player is directly experiencing the kind of limitations that a depressed person might have.
That is really cool. That is not what Actual Sunlight was about.
Yeah, no, Actual Sunlight is much more about a story that's told about a person, and the players are just taken along for the ride.
Like the short film.
Exactly, yeah. We get to react to what the main character is doing, but we never actually get to experience his motivations. And so, you know, it becomes kind of just an overwhelmingly sad story, which if the developer was trying to do, then sure, that's great. But I would say that, you know, getting a person into the mindset of an individual like that is a much more strong experience.
So after I play Depression Quest, then I will be able to understand depressive humor?
Well, no, I think you'll need a little bit more than just one game.
How many other games use empathy?
I don't know, but I would like to find some.
Hey, I've got an idea.
What's that?
If we break the fourth wall, then we can ask the viewers if they know any games that use empathy. Then we can play them.
Okay, and how do we break the fourth wall?
Look over there.
Where?
There.
You're not pointing anywhere.
And tell them about Patreon.
I would tell them if you pointed in the direction for me to look at.
I am pointing.
Okay.
And tell them about the website.
Do people even go to websites anymore?
Tell them about www.gamesover.coffee.
Yeah, okay.
Did you tell them?